Easy, easy. All right. I think we are all set. And all right, yep, it's about that time anyway, so I
Bring
will
him
let
on.
everybody in.
Bring him on. Oh, Riley, you can make me a co-host because you're turning off the chat.
Welcome everyone. As you're joining, we're just chatting a little bit. Mitch, if I include you as a co-host, you will still receive messages. So I'll go ahead and keep you off.
Okay, sounds good then.
Okay. Welcome everyone. I see lots of familiar faces. Thank you for joining us again. For those of you who may be joining for the first time, my name is Riley Franco. I am a staff member with the AARP Nevada team, and I'm joined today by our wonderful instructor, Mitch Menik, who will take over class in just a couple of minutes after we go over some housekeeping items. You will notice that you are muted right now. That's just through the duration of our class. At the end, we will open up the microphones to be able to ask questions about today's instruction to Mitch. You also should see on your screen some instructions. So if you would like to say hello in our chat, we always love to know where you all are joining from. It makes us so happy to see the reach of Mitch's class. And sometimes we've had folks as far away as Europe. We've had Paris. We've got some regulars in Alaska and Hawaii. So we always love to see that. Also, please rename yourself to match your registration. And you can do that by hovering over your video square. You should see a blue button pop up with three little dots. You can click on that and then you will see the option to rename. And lastly, if you change your speaker view to, excuse me, if you change your view to speaker view instead of gallery view, you'll be able to see Mitch a lot clearer during today's instruction. So that, of course, is in the upper right-hand corner of your Zoom screen. You'll see that button. You can toggle back and forth between the views. Another point, we will be turning off the chat function to the entire class throughout instruction today. So you can still send me a message in the chat, and I'm happy to help you with any technical issues or questions. As you think of questions you'd like to ask Mitch, you can certainly put them in the chat, but we just take that off during class so it doesn't interrupt everyone else's experience. So let's see, what else? Oh, these sessions will be recorded, but as you may know, your video will not appear in our recording. So feel free to turn your camera on or off, whatever you are most comfortable with. And I believe that is really all of our housekeeping. So let's get to what we're all really here for. Mitch, if you would take it away.
Well done, Riley. Thank you so much for being here and supporting this class and for making this all happen. So welcome everybody. We're going to start sitting down today instead of just jumping right up and getting into it. So we're going to begin. And as you do the exercises, do it at your own pace. Don't overdo it. We do a lot of breath work. If you start to feel a little bit dizzy or anything from all the oxygen, then just kind of slow your breathing down a little bit. I mean, or don't take such a deep breath. Otherwise, take a good deep breath because oxygen is really good for you and the muscles like that. So let's start with three heart opening breaths. So palms in front of the abdomen and inhale, just give it a nice big stretch. And exhale, two more times through the nose. Let's inhale and stretch. And exhale, let's do one more time. Inhale, give it a nice big stretch. And exhale. Okay, so this is a stretch strength and balance class, but it's designed to bring the mind into the body. Let's begin by doing some nice little stretching exercise for the neck. I want you to bring your right ear to the right shoulder and just bring it down. And if you're comfortable, you can take your right hand and put a little pressure down if you want. Otherwise, just leave it like it is. Just make it work for you and just hold it there for a moment. Okay, now we're in position. So let's breathe into it. So when you inhale, feel the body expand. When you exhale, just relax into that stretch. Again, through the nose, let's inhale. And then exhale, just relax. We'll do one more breath and then we'll breathe into a release. So it's inhale and exhale, just relax. You can put your arm to the side. That's number three. So in number four, we're inhaling, we're coming up, and then exhale. Now let's bring the ear down to the other side. Again, you can put this hand down for a little pressure, just leave it open. Just drop your ear down. Either way makes whatever works best for you. So now let's do three breaths. So through the nose, let's inhale and exhale, just a little bit of pressure. Again, inhale and exhale, just a little bit more. Again, inhale and exhale for breath number three. Now when we inhale, we're coming up. And when we're exhaling, just kind of wobble ahead a little bit, just kind of relax, get everything back to normal. All right, now let's take the right hand, put it behind your head, and bring the elbow across your body and look behind you. Then inhale and exhale, just to stretch a little bit more. Inhale and exhale for breath two. Inhale and exhaling, number three, relaxing deeply into the stretch. Now when we inhale, slowly come up and exhale, relax. Now the same thing with the other side, palm behind the head, bring the elbow across the body, look behind you. Then inhale and exhale into a stretch. Again, inhale and exhale, stretching a little bit more. Again, inhale. When you're exhaling, you're relaxing into the stretch. Now when we inhale, slowly coming up and exhale. So the way I teach, when I say relax or stretch a little more, they're pretty much the same thing. So you're just kind of relaxing and embellishing the stretch just by bringing your whole mind into it. That helps bring the mind into the body, which relaxes the mind, which also further relaxes the body. Now let's bring both hands up and just lift up. I want you to inhale, lift up. Now when you exhale, pull your arms down and kind of the elbows come behind. You're squeezing the shoulder blades together. Then inhale up and exhale two. Inhale up and exhale three. Then inhale up. Now when you exhale, just lower the palms down in front of you and bend the elbows and make a little fist and put your thumbs out to the side. Keep your elbows tucked in and we're gonna squeeze the shoulder blades from this angle. So inhale, pull open the chest, squeeze the shoulders, and then exhale for breath one. Inhale and exhale. I wanna try that a little bit different. First, let's take the inhale. Now exhale, squeeze. Then inhale, come back, and then exhale, squeeze. Then inhale, come back, and exhale, squeeze. Then inhale up, and then exhale. Bring your elbows up to shoulder height. Bring your fists so they're pointing towards each other. We're gonna pull the elbows back. So let's inhale, then exhale, squeeze. Then inhale, and exhale, squeeze. Inhale and exhale, squeeze, then inhale up and then exhale, relax. Okay, let's take the left hand around the or right hand around the waist. Bring your left hand up and just lean over, elbows straight, and just let that pull on you a little bit. So inhale, lift up and stretch, exhale, hold it. Inhale just a little bit more and exhale, hold it. Inhale just a little more. And then exhale, slowly come out of this and switch arms. Elbow straight. Bring it over the head. Then inhale, lift up and stretch a little more. Exhale, hold it. Inhale just a little bit more. Exhale, hold it. Inhale for number three and exhale into the stretch. Now slowly come out of this and relax. Now shake the arms, shift the shoulders and bobble ahead. Now speaking of the shoulders, let's do some shoulder shrugs. So when you inhale, bring both shoulders up to the ears and exhale, bring it down. Again, inhale, bring up to the ears and exhale, bring it down. Inhale, bring them up to the ears and then exhale, bring them down. Now let's just do the right and then the left. Start with the right side. Inhale up and feel the stretch down to the hip and exhale, other side. Inhale, bring it up and then exhale. That's one set. Right side up and then exhale down. Left side up and then exhale. Let's do one more time each side. Inhale up, exhale down. Inhale up and then exhale down. Now clasp your hands in front of you. And we're going to just stretch out a little bit. So when you inhale, bring the palms up to the chest, roll them forward. Exhale, keep the shoulders over the hips, but extend the arms into a stretch. Then inhale and exhale. Can you feel it in your forearm, maybe? And then inhale, lift up. When you exhale, look up to stretch. One more breath. Inhale, just stretch out a little bit more. Now when we exhale, slowly lower the palms down. Okay, I invite you to stand up and put the chair off to the side. Just a little bit for a moment. We'll grab the chair in a moment. So I just want you to just relax and go for a walk with me. Just relax. Yeah, just bringing your feet up a little bit and just relaxing the arms. Just getting the body moving a little bit. Just not too much. Just kind of make it work. Just kind of feel relaxed doing this. Yeah. Okay, now just swing the arms a little bit more. The knees come up just a little bit more. Okay, now slowly bring it down. So just bring the heart rate up just a little bit. Now just, let's just start bouncing the knees a little bit, just relaxing the body. Bring your feet in so they're about hip width apart. And relax the arms, relax the shoulders. And bring a nice vibration into the body. So the other day I tried one of these vibration machines. It was called Zaz. And I was asked what I thought about it. I couldn't see any difference on that expensive machine other than doing what we're doing here. It's amazing. I mean, the machines are good if you can't move the body too good that and you're just trying to recover from something. The vibration movement will heal you really good. But other than that, we're doing it. So now, while you're bouncing the knees, let's start shaking the palms. So you're bringing a nice vibration into the body. Nice vibration. So everything starts to vibrate as you shake things around a little bit. Now let's add a little wiggle the hips. All right, now shimmy the shoulders. You got to bobble the head while you shimmy the shoulders too. Yeah, and just shake it all up. So you're all shook up, just let go. Now just kind of let yourself go free. Just kind of go around, just shake it up, loosen up, kick the legs out a little bit while you're shaking. Yeah. And that's good. Now just stop. Let's do three heart opening breaths. Palms in front of the abdomen and inhale, give it a nice big stretch. And exhale again through the nose. Let's inhale and stretch. And exhale one more time. Inhale and stretch. And exhale. All right. So we've done the upper body pretty good. Let's step forward with your right foot. Put the hands in the hips. Well, inhale on the way up, exhale on the way down. Keep that front knee locked so you're stretching underneath the leg. So inhale. Now when you exhale, just hinge at the hip so you're keeping your back straight. You might have to lift your head up just a little bit, but not too much. Just trying to keep the back straight. So you can see me in the mirror to get another angle. So let's add the breath to this. So inhale and exhale. Just relax a little bit more into that stretch for the back of the leg. Again, through the nose, big long inhale. And exhaling, just relaxing a little bit more into that stretch for the back of the leg, starting to feel good, huh? Again, inhale, big long inhale. And exhale, just relax a little bit more. It's a wonderful stretch. It feels so good. We could do this more, but we won't. So inhale, come on up. And exhale, shake the legs out a little bit. Now let's do the same thing on the other side. Step forward with the other foot. And then hands in the hips, so inhale and exhale. You can bend the back knee, but keep that front leg straight until you don't come down any further and hold it there. This, the muscle has a little antagonist action here, which gives it a chance to get used to this. Now, here we go. So through the nose, let's inhale and exhale. Just relax into that stretch for the back of the leg. Again, inhale and exhale. Oh, it should feel kind of good for you now. Again, inhale and exhale. Don't be too painful. Just make you kind of feel good. Enjoy it. Inhale, come on up. And exhale, relax. Everything you do, you want to feel good. Let's do a forward bend now. Palms in front of the abdomen. Feet are together as close as you can. So inhale, reach out to the side and exhale into a stretch. Then roll the palms up, stretch through the abdomen, and then exhale, reach out. Keep the back straight. You're just hinging at the hips and dropping the arms down. And we give the antagonist action a little chance to let go. So here we go. Through the nose, let's inhale and exhale. Just relax a little bit more into that stretch for the back of the legs. Again, through the nose, let's inhale, big long inhale and exhale. Just relaxing a little bit more. You don't have to touch the floor. That's not what it's all about. Again, inhale and exhale. Just relax a little bit more into that stretch for the back of the legs. Now, when we inhale, let's come on up nice and slow. If you need to, you can bend your knees. It's okay. And exhale, otherwise keep them locked. All right, then just relax and just kick the legs out a little bit, shake the arms into the shoulders and bobble the head. Now, put your feet about hip width apart this time. We're gonna rotate the rest, but this is more of a stretch for the back of the legs, but we'll also stretch the hips out as we're coming up for the most part. So it's inhale, I want you to just expand. When you exhale, just slowly come down your right side. Lock those knees and push it around. So you stretch it through the back of the legs. And when you're inhaling up, feel that right hip stretching through, just opening up. And exhale down, feel the left hip coming, moving across the body. You feel it through the back of the legs and inhaling up, you're feeling it in the right hip. And exhale down for the left hip. Stretching through the back of the legs, and then inhale up. And when you get to the top, we're going to reverse. Now exhale down the other way. So now you're feeling the stretch in your left hip as you're coming down slowly. Going across your body, feeling that nice stretch through the back of the legs, and then inhale up. You're feeling it in your left hip as you're coming up slowly. And exhale down, just hinging at the hip. The back should be straight, moving it around. And inhale up, feel it in your left hip. And exhale down, you feel a little bit in the right hip. Moving it around, and inhale up. Now when you get to the top, we're gonna hold it. So exhale, relax. All right, now kick the legs out, shake the arms, shouldn't shoulder, bobble the head, just kind of loosen up the whole body. Oh boy, that's so good. That's half the fun of it, just relaxing and loosening up. I want you to really relax in your mind so you have a good time. That's what it's all about. This is the only moment we got is right here, and we get to enjoy it. It's our time. All right, now, let's try a couple of other things. I want to bring your right knee up and left, your right knee up and left hand up. How are we doing? Okay, slowly bring it down. Let's try the other side. Bring your left hand up and your right knee up. A right knee up, right hand, left knee, and then come down. I'm sorry, I got mixed up. Okay, let's try the other side. Bring your left knee up, right knee up and left hand up. And good, slowly coming down. It's a little challenging. There's a chair, you can bring your chair a little closer if you need to hold on to it, okay? So other side. Bring it up and then come down. Let's try that again. Right knee up, left hand up, and then come down. One more time, other side. Bring it up and then slowly come down. All right, now let's do some heel lifts. Now this, you probably need to use the chair to do, or maybe you don't, but it's here for you. We start with both at the same time. So you might want to go behind your chair and use this to hold on to. Again, if you don't need to, do a freestyle. Make it work for you. Don't overdo these exercises. So through the nose, let's inhale both heels up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and slowly bring it down. Let's do two more sets. Inhale up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And slowly, slowly bring it down. Do one more time through the nose. Inhale. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And slowly, slowly bring it down. Okay, now let's do the right and then the left. Again, you probably definitely have to hold on to the chair. So we're going to bring our inside leg up, whatever side of the chair you're standing on. I'll bring my left leg up now, and I'm going to bring the right heel up. So get my chair a little closer for balance. So inhale up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And slowly bring it down. Again, inhale up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And slowly bring it down. Again, inhale up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And slowly bring it down. Now, before we do the other side, just kick the legs out a little bit. Make sure you you're seeing me okay. So now we're going to do the other leg. So bring your other foot up. And let's begin. Inhale up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. If you want to put your hand on a table that's by you, that might be safer than a chair. Actually, I got to angle my chair a little bit. So it can support me better. So let's try that again. So it's inhale up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and slowly bring it down. Other side up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and slowly come on down. And kick the legs out a little bit and shake them up, shimmy the shoulders, and bobble ahead. How are we doing so far? Everyone's working out good? Let's do three heart opening breaths, palms in front of the abdomen. And inhale, give it a nice big stretch. And exhale, again, through the nose. Let's inhale and stretch. And exhale, one more time. Inhale for a nice deep stretch. And exhale. So now I invite you to just take a moment and have a little sip of water. So you should always try to have water for my classes. I should have told you that at the beginning of the class, so I don't interrupt your routine here. But water is so delicious, and the body is all electric, and we need water to function the best possible. So sometimes when we're not feeling good, it's because we're dehydrated. And when you get thirsty, honestly, it's too late then. You're already over the hill with that. I mean, so try to keep drinking water throughout the day because it's so very, very good for you. All right, now, let's go into a forward bend. So with your feet about hip width apart, put the palms in front of the abdomen. Knees are soft to begin with. Then inhale, let's reach out to the side, straighten the knees, and exhale into stretch. Then roll the palms up as we inhale, stretch through the abdomen, and then exhale, reach out, and then slowly lower the arms down, bend, just hinging at the hip, keeping your back straight. Okay, so now we're gonna add the breath. So it's inhale and exhale, just relax a little bit more into that stretch. See how different it is from the first time you did it. Again, inhale and exhale, just relax a little bit more. One more time, inhale. And exhale, just relax a little bit more. Now when we inhale, slowly come on up. And exhale, just relax and just kick the legs out. And just walk it out a little bit. Just throw your arms around. Just let the body relax. Okay. All right. Let's do some of the same exercises we did while we're sitting down, but now we're in a standing position. But we're gonna do it just a little bit differently. I'm gonna add some squats to it. So we're going to lift our arms up and squat and then come return. So through the nose, let's inhale up and then exhale, bend the knees. Now, when you're bending the knees, you just want to just kind of keep the shoulders over the hips as much as you can and just kind of keep yourself in balance. It's up to you how low you want to go. Now inhale up, and then exhale, slowly come down. Again, inhale up, exhale, slowly makes three. Inhale up, and exhale, slowly makes four. Inhale up, and exhale, slowly. Let's do five more. Inhale up, and then exhale, slowly come down. Inhale up, and then exhale, slowly come down. So you're kind of sitting down when you do this. Inhale up, and then exhale, slowly coming down. Inhale up, and then exhale, slowly. Let's do two more times. Inhale up, exhale, slowly coming down. Then inhale up, and exhale, down. Then inhale, one more up. Hold it here and exhale, relax the arms. Let's do three, kick the legs out for a second. Shake the arms, shimmy the shoulders, and now three heart opening breaths. Palms in front of the abdomen and inhale, give it a nice big stretch. And exhale, two more. Inhale and stretch. And exhale, oh, one more time. Inhale and stretch and exhale. So I just noticed my heart rate's up quite a bit now. How about you? Just like a little soft stroll, just relax the body. And I'm starting to get hot now, which is good. All right. Now, let's just, I want to do some more twisting exercise a little bit. So let's take the right hand, put it around, put it behind our back or behind our neck. Then I want you to inhale. And exhale, bring the arm across the body so you're in position. So inhale and exhale a little bit more into that stretch. And then inhale and exhale, completes breath two. Inhale and exhale. Now we're up to breath three. On breath four, we're inhaling, coming up, and exhaling, relaxing. Let's go to the other side. And behind the head, let's inhale up, exhale into position. Then inhale and exhale, one. Inhale and exhale, that's two. Inhale and exhale, that's three. Then inhale up and exhale, relax. Shake the arms, shift the shoulders and bobble the head. Kick the legs out a little bit. All right. Now let's try the right ear to the right shoulder routine. So bring the right ear to the right shoulder. Bring the hand up if you want, or just leave it open. And just a little pressure. Let's add the breath. Inhale and exhale. Two more breaths. Inhale and exhale. Always inhale through the nose. Inhale and exhale. Fourth one, we're inhaling up and exhale. Let's go to the other side and around, or just drop your head down. Either way, make it work for you. Kind of feels good to you, huh? So let's inhale and exhale, just relax. Again, inhale and exhale. Let's do one more time. Inhale and exhale. Now when we inhale, slowly come up and exhale and just bobble the head. So, you know, there was a time when I wasn't doing too much exercise with my neck. And I'd look to turn, you know, to see behind me when I'm driving a car or either way. And I'd find pains in here. Since I've been doing this, they're starting to go away. So it's a really nice little exercise to do that. So just relax now. Let's take a chair and sit down for a moment. By the way, have a sip of water. So I talk a lot, so I definitely need the water, but it doesn't matter. You're still following along and doing everything I'm doing. So we need water. Water is really good for us. Let's clasp our hands in front of us. So when we inhale, bring the clasped hands up to our chest and exhale into a stretch. Then inhale, exhale a little bit more. Now when we inhale, lift the palms up. When we exhale, look up to stretch. One more breath. Inhale, lift up through the back. And then exhale, lower the palms down. All right, now let's just sit and relax for a second. I just want you to bring your heart rate back down just for a little bit. So you can lower your eyes to the earth or close your eyes, whatever you're most comfortable. So when you're inhaling, I want you to be aware of the body expanding. When you're exhaling, you're just completely relaxing. Just let your body absorb what we've done so far. And let the body normalize here. First of all, if you're like me, I'm gasping for a little bit more air in my body. My muscles are calling for more oxygen. We put them to the test. So now we're relaxing and giving them what they need just for a brief moment in time. But this moment in time is a moment where there is no time. We don't need any time over here. And the whole key is to relax and bring the mind right into the body. When you do that, the mind relaxes. When the mind relaxes, the body can relax, because normally the body can never relax until the mind relaxes. So as soon as you relax the mind, the body relaxes. And what happens is it releases tension and tightness in the body. This allows for a much freer flow of energy throughout the body. So we've been actively drinking water now, and so the body is well hydrated. So things are starting to become very sharp and clear. Our mind becomes much clearer because of the hydration and the movement. Movement is very important in the body. Just be aware of the body expanding on your inhale and completely and deeply relaxing as you exhale. Okay, now let's open our eyes. Clasp your hands in front of your abdomen. So when we inhale, bring the clasped hands up to our chest, roll them forward. As we exhale, stretch the body out. Then inhale, exhale a little more deeply into our stretch again. And then inhale, lift up. When we exhale, look up to stretch. One more breath, inhale, stretch it out. And then exhale, lower the palms down. Take your right hand to the left knee. When you inhale, reach up, grab the chair, and exhale, pull yourself around into a twist. Then inhale and exhale a little bit more deeply to that twist. Now, when we inhale, slowly come on the other side and exhale into position. Then inhale and exhale into the twist. One more breath. Inhale, twist a little more deeply, and exhale, come on back to our front for starting position. All right, now we do some more stretching and a little bit more coordination with the arm and the knee. So when we do this, everything will be done with the breath. We want to take nice big breaths and always try to inhale through the nose, because there's little hairs in the nose that filter out the impurities, your first line of defense for your immune system. Okay, starting with your right side. So it's inhale, bring the right knee up and the arm up and stretch, and then exhale, very slowly come down. Other side, inhale, bring it up and stretch, and then exhale, come on down. Stretching is such a wonderful way to exercise the body. Inhale, it promotes really good strength in the body, and exhale, come on down. Other side, inhale, give it a good stretch, and then exhale. Let's go again. Inhale, lift up and stretch, and then exhale. Other side. Inhale, lift up and stretch, and then exhale. We're going to do three more times to make a total of six. Right side, inhale, up and stretch, and then exhale, slowly come down. Left side, give it a good stretch, and then exhale, two more times. Inhale through the nose, and exhale through the nose or the mouth, probably about through the mouth that's more comfortable right now. Inhale, lift up and stretch, and exhale. When you exhale through the mouth, you cool your body down a little bit more efficiently. One more time. Inhale up, and then exhale down over to the left. Inhale up, and then exhale. Let's do both at the same time. All right, now. We're going to lift both knees up. You need to kind of pivot on your behind to do that. If you're too far back in the chair, you can't pivot. So we need to kind of scooch up just a little bit. So you're more in the middle of the chair. So you have plenty of room to lean up and lean back and pull your knees up. If it's too difficult to get your knees up without using your hands, use your hands. You can put your hands on the bottom of the chair, or you can even pull on the back if that's more comfortable for you. Just kind of work it out for you. I'm going to do it freestyle with both hands up, and we want to stretch through the body if we're able to. So through the nose, let's inhale, bring both knees up, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, come on down. Again, through the nose, inhale, up, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, that's 2. Inhale, up, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold it down. Come on down. Okay, that's 3. Inhale, up, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 5, 4, 3, 2. That's 4. Inhale, up. 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 5, 4, 3, 2. That's 5 more to go. Inhale, up. 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 5, 4, 3, 2. Okay, 6. Inhale, up. 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 5, 4, 3, 2. Okay, 3 more. Inhale, up, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 5, 4, 3, 2. Okay, one more. Inhale, up, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, now just take a moment and just relax in the chair. Just throw your arms around, just kind of wiggle it, wiggle the waist and shimmy the shoulders, bobble the head, just kind of loosen up. That's a pretty intense exercise, I know. I like that. It's a good one. All right, now, this next one, we're going to bring our right foot up and extend our left arm. When you extend the left arm, you want to extend it from the shoulder, keep the shoulder over the hip, and just pull on your back. So you're pulling on that muscle on your back when we do that. So let's just see. I'm going to twist a little side so you can see me a little better. Take your right foot up and push the toes forward and stretch. Okay, so the shoulder should be over the hip, sitting up straight, and we're pulling on that muscle that wraps around your shoulder blade. And this kind of helps massage it a little bit. So now let's bring the toes back. Lift the elbows up, so you're stretching underneath the leg, and you're lifting up through the side here. It's a really nice body stretch. Okay, that's one time. Let's go 5 more. Push the toes forward and stretch. Pull the toes back, elbow up, 4 to go. Push the toes forward to stretch. Pull the toes back, elbow up, 3 more times. Push the toes forward to stretch. Pull the toes back, elbow up, 2 more times. Push the toes forward and stretch. Pull the toes back, elbow up, 1 more. Push the toes forward to stretch. Pull the toes back, elbow up. Now come to the center. Now we're going to rotate the ankle and the shoulder 6 times each way. And when you do, again, you keep the sit up straight, keep the shoulder over the hip, but reach out in your arm so you're pulling on that same muscle that wraps around your scapula, your shoulder blade. Toes to the inside first. Ready? Begin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now hold it here. We're going to go the other way. So when I have you keeping your leg up, just bear with me. So it's really good to kind of get into the exercise. Now it's the opposite way. And always inhale through the nose. Ready? Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Five, 6. Okay, now bring your foot down, take both hands and vigorously massage your thigh, the upper part of your leg. And you can lift your knee up and come underneath the thigh. And put a lot of pressure in there. Really good for your circulation, kind of relaxes the tissues, the fascia that's all around that area. Kind of when you push and pull and everything, it kind of stretches things out. Now come down to the knee. And again, put your fingers into every little nook and cranny all around the knee. You know, put your meniscus, your patella, all that stuff that makes up your knee. Okay, now we're going to push down the front of the leg with the head up. We do it one time. So slowly push down with pressure, with pressure. Keep the, you're just hinging at the hip as you push down so you keep your back straight. You're not curving the back. And then very slowly, let's pull it up. Very slowly, come on up. Okay, now let's do the sides the same way. Pushing down, hinging at the hip. And very slowly pulling up. Let's come behind the leg, come down the back of the calf, pushing down, hinging at the hip. Head is up a little, and then pulling up. Okay, now very gently sweep the leg, just kind of smooth out the energy, kind of give it just a surface massage. You're not going deep, okay? All right, good. Now we're going to bring this, bring your right leg up and extend the arms. We're going to shake the leg and the foot and the arms and the fingers vigorously. And I want you to count with me from 10 backwards. So when you count, I want you to shout it out because it's great for relieving stress. So if you're in tight quarters, there's neighbors in the other room or anything like that, well, they could have been here and joined us too. So here we go. Ready? Begin. 10, 9. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, good. That's great. So nice to see more than one person on the camera here. That's great. I like to see when the groups of people are doing it. Other foot is up. Arms are out. No. Other foot is up. I'm sorry. Push the toes forward. Keep the shoulder over the hip, and I want you to reach out as hard as you can, keeping the shoulder over the hip. So you're pulling on that muscle that wraps around the shoulder blade. And then pull the toes back, put the palm on the shoulder, lift the elbow up. So you're stretching all the way down through here, your lower back, or this side of the back, and you're stretching underneath the leg. Okay, so we're gonna do five more. Push the toes forward and stretch. Keep the shoulder over the hip and pull on that back. And then bring the palm on the shoulder, pull the toes back, lift the elbows up, stretch the back, back is straight. Okay, four more, push the toes forward to stretch, pull the toes back, elbow up, three more, push the toes forward to stretch, pull the toes back, elbow up, two to go, push the toes forward to stretch, pull the toes back, elbow up, one more time, push the toes forward, pull the toes back, elbow up, come to the center, and let's rotate the ankle and the shoulder six times each way. Remember to sit up straight, keep the shoulder over the hip, but pull in your arm, pull out. There you go. Inside first, ready, begin. One, two, three, four, five, six. Now let's go the other way. One, two, three, four, five, six. Now bring the foot down, take both hands and vigorously massage your thigh. Again, you can lift the knee up to get underneath a little bit. Put a lot of pressure. You can press down with your palms, pushing into the meat of the thigh. This is good. Yep. This helps improve your circulation. You can go circular anyway, whatever kind of feels good to you. You know what to do. Now dig your fingers and thumbs into the knee. And all the little nooks and crannies. Kind of just bring a lot of energy into those areas. This is very healthy for bringing more blood. Everything we do in rubbing and pushing and everything brings more blood into those areas, and the blood has all the goodies for you. That's how the body restores itself. It's through the blood. Okay, now let's come down the front, and with you're just hinging at the hip, and with pressure, we're coming down slowly. Just kind of smoothing things out. There's no muscle here, but there's fascia that's connected tissue. And then slowly, slowly come on up. Okay, good. Now we're gonna do the sides. Slowly pushing down with pressure. The strength is also, it's exercise. This is muscle building and then coming up, or muscle toning, I should say. Coming up, again, pushing down. And pulling up. Now let's come behind the knee, pushing down. And pulling up. Again, now let's just sweep the knee, the thigh all the way down the leg. If you're coming down, that's what to keep the back straight. So you're just hinging at the hip, keeping the head up. Okay, now let's bring this left leg up and shake it all about with the arms, legs, and fingers. Start shaking. And then I want you to count loudly to get rid of any stagnant energy that's left in your body from 10 backwards. Ready, begin. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good job. Well done. Shouting it out is really good. Now, the challenge is to do both at the same time. It's really not that hard. We've done the right and then the left. We just do them both up. So let's bring both feet up. Sit up straight. Push the toes forward. Lift the arms up. Keep the shoulders over the hips, but just kind of pulling. Pulling them out. Okay, good. And this pulls on that muscle. All right. Now pull the toes back. Palms on the shoulders. Lift the elbows up, stretching underneath the legs. Yeah. Oh, that's so good. Okay, that's one. Push the toes forward and stretch. Okay. Pull the toes back, elbows up, sit up straight. Okay. We have, that's two, so we have four more. Push the toes forward to stretch. Okay. Pull the toes back, elbows up. Three more. Push the toes forward to stretch. Pull the toes back, elbows up. Two more, push the toes forward to stretch. Pull the toes back, elbows up. Okay, one more, push the toes forward and stretch. Pull the toes back, elbow up. Now come to the center, keep the legs up. And we're gonna rotate the ankle and the shoulder six times each way. But remember, we're sitting up straight. We're pulling on our shoulders. So you're pulling on the muscle that wraps around your back. Ready? Begin. One, two, three, four, five, six. Now I go the opposite way. One, two, three, four, five, six. Now bring the feet down, take both hands and vigorously massage both thighs at the same time. You can lift the leg up here and there, just get underneath, all around the insides. With pressure, push down on your palms. You know, just kind of put, tuck your, you know, push your thumbs in. It's good for strengthening for your arms to do massage like this with pressure. Now around the knees, put your fingers in every little nook and cranny, digging your thumb in. Yeah. All this tissue. There's some muscle around the joints. That's what helps the helps you with everything, walking. Okay, now just hinge at the hips as you're pushing down both of the shins, nice and slow, and then slowly pulling up. Okay, let's do the outside, hinging at the hip, the head up, pulling down, and then pulling up. Now let's go to the inside, pushing down and pulling up. Now let's go behind the legs, pushing down and pulling up. And then just sweep out, sweep the legs just very smoothly, just kind of brushing them out, all on the surface. We're not pushing really hard. And then down the front, hinging with the head up. Okay. Now let's bring both legs up and shake them all about with our arms, legs, and fingers, counting loudly from 10 backwards. Ready, begin. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, four, three, two, one. Come on down. So as we did that, those went through that set, you should find yourself being able to keep your legs up a little bit more, gaining a lot of strength in the body, and also, you know, maybe not so much winded. Now, I'm very winded now. You should be too, because I'm giving my 100% when I do the class, which is what we want you to do too, is just give your 100%. About 70% of your ability works just fine to do this class. You don't have to overdo it to make it work for you. So let's just, let's do a little body tapping exercise. Stay seated. You might want to take your glasses off. You might also want to take a sip of water real quick before we conclude. That's a good idea, huh? All right. Let's start tapping the top of our head. Okay, come with the crown. Start coming down the back of the head. Come behind the ears. On top of the ears. Not on the ears themselves, just on the head, the bone, yeah. Okay, all around the temples, the temples, the temples. Okay, then come around the forehead, all around the forehead. This is very stimulating for the connective tissue. So all around the head, we're using the tips of our fingers, but you're tapping pretty hard. So you want to bring some blood flow into that area. This is what makes you look good. And now all around the eyebrows, eyebrows, eyebrows. So we're actually stimulating all these energy centers throughout the body. We have 366 of them in total throughout the entire body. Now come down below the eyes, on top of the eyes, there's eye sockets. Now just slowly come down below the nose. There's on the upper level of the gum line of the teeth, come up to the back teeth, up into the cheeks, and then come back down. Okay, let's jump down to the lower level in the gum line and then just glide up to the back teeth and then come back down. Okay, now all around the chin, the chin, the chin, the chin, all around the chin. Yeah, come underneath the jaw and start coming below the jaw. And until you're behind the jawbone, below the ears, there's some soft tissue in that area. You want to tap that, stimulate that section, that area. Okay, now I want you to, next thing is scrunchy, called scrunchy face and then open face. We do three sets. And when you do this, this is really good. It makes you look good. So we're gonna start by scrunching up the face as tight as we can. And then on the opposite, called open face, you can actually make a sound and stick your tongue out. Just a nice release and just let yourself go. And it's really good for all makes it just improves your overall circulation, but makes you look good in the face because it brings a lot of blood in the area. So make it really tight, just scrunch it up. Just scrunch really tight, squeeze hard. Yeah, okay, squint the eyes, squint the nose. On the count of three, we're gonna do just the opposite, called open face. Ready? One, two, three. Okay, two more times. Give it a good squeeze. Scrunch it up. You, not only the face, you can do the whole body. Just really tight. Everything's tight. Okay? Okay. One, two, three. Okay, one more time. Give it a good scrunch. This is good for you. I know it looks silly, but it's so good. Oh, it makes you look great and it feels good. One, two, three. Okay, close your eyes for a second, or just lower your eyes to the earth and just feel that tingling in your face. This is every cell getting washed and rinsed, restoring you to your state of perfect health. Just like you are always perfect in every way. Okay, open your eyes, put your right hand out, thumb up, drop the head down and take the left hand. And I want you to tap really hard so you send shockwaves all the way down. It's a good for the lungs. This almost makes me want to cough. I'm just tapping so loud. On top of the shoulder, top of the shoulder, top of the shoulder, top of the biceps. Stay top of the elbow, start coming down the forearm to the wrist, top of thumb, front of the fist, pinky the karate chop, lower wrist, start coming up the forearm, hitting elbow, 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 okay, tricep, 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 armpit, armpit, armpit. Okay, now upper part of the chest, 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 Now let's go to the other side, drop the head down and tap up really hard. Okay, on top of the shoulder, top of the shoulder. All right, top of the bicep, top of the forearm, and start coming down the forearm. Tap hard. Wrist, 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 top of thumb, front of fist. Pinky the karate chop, lower wrist. Start coming up the forearm. This is so good for bringing blood into the area. It's great for elasticity of the skin. Okay, now do the tricep, 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 armpit, armpit, armpit. Okay, let's go back to the upper part of the chest. Now, tapping the chest and shouting it out is a great way to relieve stagnant energy in the body, and it sets yourself free. So free, you're gonna join me in just having a good time laughing at the end, because laughter is truly the best medicine. There's nothing like a good laugh, and it's very contagious. So Riley, if you can allow everyone to turn off their, turn on their mics, that'd be great. All right. You might have to reach over for a second and turn on your mics if you want. Go ahead. You don't have to have your mic on, but it just sounds cool when we all do it together. So follow me. When I go ha, you go ha. If I go ha ha, you go ha ha. Now let me go first. Ready? Ah! Ah! Wait a minute, I didn't do the second one yet. And let's play Santa Claus. Oh! 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 You guys did great. Thank you for joining me. I appreciate that. Okay, now while you're tapping your abdomen, slowly lift your head up and pull your behind up with it. There we go. All right, now reach forward and do your kidneys. Lean forward, hip hinge. Don't curve your back. Come on down, do your tailbone, 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 tailbone. Do your buttocks, 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 buttocks. Okay, come on down the back of the legs.
Mitch, I'm so sorry you got muted. If you could unmute yourself. Mitch, this is Riley. If you can hear me, you are muted.
Yeah.
There we go. Thank you.
You mean I was muted throughout all that? Oh my.
just in the last couple of maybe 30 seconds.
Okay. Well, y'all got it. We all got it, right? Y'all swept pretty good. I invite you to sit down for a second. And while we're relaxing here, I want you to just soak in the energy that you just created from doing the class. And it's our opportunity to, the chat is now open. Riley, I'll turn it over to you for a moment if you have any special announcements you'd like to make.
Of course, thank you. Again, Thank you so much, Mitch. This is always a wonderful class, and I know so many of us on the on Zoom today share that sentiment, as you'll see in the chat. I did want to mention, though, that your other classes are available to everyone. If you haven't ever joined us for one of Mitch's other classes, please do. And I'm going to share that schedule with you right now. Please know that all of the classes are recorded as well and are available to you on our YouTube page. That information is going to be up on your screen momentarily. Those are available on demand and for as long as you need. So please take advantage of that. You should be able to see that schedule now. Mitch, I'm going to start scrolling for questions, but do you have any closing remarks?
Yes, there's one very important closing. I'm adding a new homework assignment for you, and that is within this class, and that's to tap down the body every day. And just take a moment, and you can spend a lot more time on one area tapping your body. So if you feel a pain in some area, tap. And what does that do? It brings blood into the area, and the blood helps heal you. As long as it's not something serious. And you know, if there's any doubt about anything, just check with your doctor about these things that I tell you about, because I'm not a doctor. I've been doing teaching classes for, probably 21 years now, teaching. And I've always kind of exercised a little bit, and actually exercised a lot, because I'm a big believer in exercise. I think exercise is probably the best way to heal your body. In fact, I don't think it, I know it. You want to heal your body, make yourself feel good. The best thing you can do is just move the body. And it's just, otherwise if you get, the body gets in pain when it sits around too much. You got to get up and move. And sometimes we get sciatica from sitting down so much. And the cure for sciatica is to stand up and walk around a little bit. You know, that's one of the best cures for that. It's just to move the body. So having said that, let me ask you guys, if there's any questions that you have. Well, while you're thinking about that, don't forget the intestine exercise too. Just push the belly out and tuck it in. Push it out and tuck it in. That's a great exercise too. So it's two homework assignments now.
Perfect. Okay. And so to avoid talking over one another, we just ask that you use your digital hand to raise your digital hand, and everyone should be able to unmute themselves to ask any questions. Alice, I see you first. Please go ahead.
Hi, Alice. Hi, I remember the phrase breathing into a stretch from years ago, but I noticed that in your exercises, sometimes the stretch seems to come on the in-breath, sometimes it seems to come after the out breath. Am I missing something? I'm trying to find if there is a consistent rhythm.
Yeah, the consistent rhythm that I try to do, and I might mess up once in a while, Alice, is just to, when you're inhaling, where the body's expanding, when we're exhaling, we're relaxing. So when we do like a stretch like this, when we're doing a static stretching, holding it, when you inhale, we're reaching out. And when we exhale, we just relax into it. And the relaxation is what really brings the exertion into it. So basically, when you're inhaling, you're taking in oxygen. When you're exhaling, the E for exhale is exertion. So think of it that way. So that's what I'm trying to accomplish. I may not always succeed in doing that, but I tried to do that. Does that help?
Yes, thank you.
You're welcome. Thanks for the question. Who else? What's up?
Teresa, please go ahead.
Hi, this is a statement, not so much a question. And I just wanted to say, I've noticed, so I've been doing this probably since June. June is when I started. And I've noticed a significant difference in how I'm even able to do the exercises. Before, I was so focused on the details, like breathing correctly. And now I'm able to feel the stretches on my side. I could never feel that. The stretches on my side. I just did it. And then eventually I got to the point where I started doing it completely. Like I had to piece it together and now it's complete. And I'm noticing that with a lot of the exercises I do.
Yeah, it's all coming together now for you. Well, yeah. Congratulations, Teresa. That's great. And thanks for being with me so long. And exercise is it's a lifestyle that you have to do it. You can't do it one day and not the next day, really. It just doesn't really do too much good. It does some good, but not too much. But when you do it consistently on a consistent basis, it's wonderful. And your whole body starts to open up and get stronger. Your balance improves. That's so right. Many good things happen from that. Mm-hmm. Thanks a lot. That comment. Carol.
Thanks, Teresa. Carol had a question in the chat that I was going to get to, but I see your hand is up. Carol, do you want to come on?
I'm going to ask the same question I typed.
Perfect.
We put our hand behind our neck and then we twist with our elbow in front of our body. Where should we, that one is it, where should we feel the stretch?
You should feel it all the way around through your lower back. Primarily in your lower back, or maybe more your mid back. So I'm feeling my mid back. I feel it all along the side here. It's just a pulse. So wherever you're feeling it, that's about where you're feeling it. I don't know how to explain it other than that. So
it's fine. Does your arm stay up level though when you turn?
No, it comes down just a little bit. So you're bringing it down across your body. It's not up here like this. It's coming down.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome. Thanks for the question.
And Mitch, I do have a question in the chat from Nancy. She says, I can't seem to pick up both legs while sitting without leaning back. Is that okay?
Well, yeah, it's okay. You can lean back and use your abdomen to pick up the legs. Actually, the whole idea is to strengthen your core. And so sometimes you just need that leverage to be able to do that. So yeah, that's fine. That's just fine. Perfect.
All right, Sanford, would you like to ask your question?
Sure. When exhaling through the mouth or nose, is that the same effect, or should we primarily exhale through the nose?
Well, you should always, let me rephrase that. You should always inhale through the nose because there's little hairs in the nose that filter out the impurities. If you exhale through the nose, you're going to keep your body a little bit warmer. If you want to cool down more efficiently, you want to exhale through the mouth. The mouth is a bigger funnel for a release.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. Thanks for the question.
And Elaine, please go ahead.
Hi, Elaine.
I don't have a question. I just wanted to compliment you. I took a car trip this past weekend, and I had to look back to merge into traffic. And I was able to turn so much further than I had ever been recently. And I immediately thought of you and thank you for giving me that ability.
Elaine, I'm so glad you brought that up because that's always been my thing. And that's where I noticed I was getting a soreness in my neck. So that's when I started doing these exercises. And in just a couple of weeks, it starts going away. So it goes away pretty quick. Thank you.
That's wonderful. Thank you all for your questions. And you can still feel free to put them in the chat, but we do have some common questions that I'd like to address really quickly. And I will put up our shared screen again for that schedule. Just a moment. There we go. So lots of questions about registration. Unfortunately, you do have to register for each class. We know that that is not ideal, but unfortunately, at this point, we don't have a better system. So if you visit our Nevada events calendar online, which I've put in the chat, but I will place again, you can see all of Mitch's classes are listed there through the end of this year, through December. So you can feel free to go through and register for any classes you'd like through the end of this year. His additional classes are listed there on your screen. And registration closes at 9 a.m. Pacific time, the day before the class. So for example, Wednesday for tomorrow, class registration closed today, Tuesday at 9 a.m. If for some reason you miss the registration deadline or have a question or need help, you can always reach us at aarpnv@aarp.org, which is that email address on your screen. And lastly, I see a lot of people saying that they've had to miss the last few classes. And luckily for you, Mitch has all of his classes recorded on our YouTube page. So again, you can visit youtube.com/AARP Nevada, and he has his own playlist of all the classes that he teaches for us here at AARP. You do not need a password. And if you'd like to subscribe to our YouTube channel, you'll be notified when we post a new video. So those were a few of the recurring questions that I saw. Let's see, Elaine, your hand is still up, or do you have another comment?
Oh, I forgot to take it down, sorry.
No, that's okay. That's why we check. I think that is all of our questions today, Mitch. Do you have anything else for us?
Yeah, I want to just thank you all for being here and being consistent. The hardest part of an exercise class truly is showing up and just have to put it in your schedule and you'll be here. You know, you make that a priority, you make it happen. And it's just not my class, any class, but I favor my class. So please come. listen, tomorrow is bone strengthening. It's similar to this class. A lot of the stretches are very similar, but we're using weights, and weights are optional. And it's up to you how much weight you want to use. And you can do it without weights if you want. So just know that. All right, that's it. Thank you all for being here. Thank you for your lovely comments. I really appreciate that. And are there any other, that's it, right? Okay, thank you again. Riley, thank you so much.
Thank you, Mitch, and we'll see you tomorrow.
Okay, bye-bye all. Thank you all.